Hi, I'm Clare Long of the White Mountain National Forest. So, you want to see a moose? Well, maybe if you know the meaning of the word moose, it'll help you find one. The word moose comes from the Native American tribe, the Algonquins, and means one of the following: twig eater, swamp dweller, mountain climber, or river wader. Which one? Stand by for the answer. The White Mountain National Forest is home to over 16,000 species of animals, most of them being insects. Of the many birds, reptiles, amphibians, and mammals, there is no other animal that attracts as much attention and awe as the moose. Moose have been a part of the forest scenery for thousands of years. The word moose comes from the Algonquins and means twig eater. It's an appropriate name because moose primarily browse on the stems and twigs of woody plants in the winter and the leaves and shoots of deciduous plants in the summer. So, how will this help you find a moose? Easy. Look for the place with the twigs. Moose prefer the early successional stage of a forest area, where forage is in abundance due to disturbance. Fire, logging, flooding, or glacial action greatly increase the quantity and quality of forage for moose, and ultimately, moose density. Besides forested habitats, moose will seek out areas near water, such as ponds, lakes, rivers, and swamps. Moose sightings are common along the notch roads of the White Mountains, including the Kankamagas Highway, Route 302 through Crawford Notch, and Route 16 through Pinkham Notch. Be aware, moose are generally docile, but will attack without warning with sharp hooves and antlers when provoked. Vehicle collisions with moose are a serious problem in North America and Europe. In North America, nearly 3,000 collisions occur each year. In New Hampshire, hundreds of moose are hit each year, with fatal results for some drivers. It is recommended that motorists use caution between dusk and dawn because that is when moose are most active and most difficult to see. Another of the area's active inhabitants is the black bear. To avoid problem encounters with bears, never leave food or scented items like deodorant or air fresheners in your car or bring it into your tent. Bears have a keen sense of smell and will detect them. Do not approach any animals, particularly young ones, as the parents may be nearby. To avoid bear encounters while hiking, make noise so that the animals know you are coming. Give all animals their space and never feed any wildlife. Stay alert and do not exceed the speed limit while driving. The wildlife of the White Mountain National Forest is magnificent, but be alert. You never know when an encounter may happen. You may even get to see a moose.